The takeover of the wastes takes place in the interim storage facility for low and intermediate level wastes at the site of the nuclear power plant. A staff of PUREM checks the protocols handed over by the nuclear power plant for each drum and measures the surface dose rate of the drums and takes smear samples from their surface. By doing this, it determines whether waste acceptance criteria are met. If so, the drum is marked with a barcode. Sixteen drums, placed in four carrying frames, are loaded on the specially designed transport vehicle. The transfer route is about 60 kilometers. After the entrance control, the transport vehicle arrives at the technological building of the central facility. Then it enters the building's loading area through the gateway monitor. Each drum is recorded before it's put in the storage area. The second element of the barrier system for the disposal of low and intermediate level radioactive waste is the reinforced concrete container made for this purpose. First, the specialist joined the precision metal shutter parts. The value of required tolerance is 2 mm. The shutter parts that come into contact with concrete are cleaned and covered with an anti-adhesive. After fixing the internal and external shutter parts with screws, the frame structure is turned upside down by a crane. The specialists remove the bottom plate and place the threaded seats needed to close the lid of the container. The needed lifting points are formed and the lid of the container is prepared as well. A consistency analysis is carried out on the fresh concrete sample to measure its fluidity. if the consistency and temperature of the concrete meet their strict technological requirements, the concrete is poured in subsequent stages, allowing time for gases to evaporate. Thanks to the special shutter vibrators, the concrete spreads evenly within the steel frame structure without inclusions. Finally, the concrete surface is smoothed and covered with a plastic film to ensure even solidification. Three days later, the container is removed from the frame structure. It is filled with water and delivered to the maturing area. If the container fulfills the impermeability requirements, its hardness test is also analyzed. A test cube is prepared for every container. After curing in water, specialists make a fracture on each cube in an accredited laboratory. If the containers meet all the strict technological requirements, they are delivered in twos to the NRWR site in Bátaapáti. The final packaging of the drums, known as overpacking, is made in the technological building where first the barcodes of the drums and the container are matched in the recording system. After this, 9 drums are put in the container by crane. In order to ensure perfect closing, a rubber gasket tape is placed between the lid and the body of the container. A concrete spacer is placed to each drum of 9 to provide resistance to floating till the spaces among the drums are filled with concrete. Then the lid is laid to the container and is tightly bolted. At the scheduled time, the transport vehicle arrives at the site. The full tube system is wetted through the feed pipe of the concrete transport vehicle and the system of the technological building. At the end of the process, a sponge ball goes through the system to remove the remaining water. During this process, a concrete sample is produced and the necessary consistency analysis is carried out. If it fulfills the requirements, the specialists start the filling through the 2 holes of the lid of the container. After this, the reinforced concrete container filled with drums is backfilled with good spreading concrete on a vibration table to fill the spaces among the drums without inclusions. As soon as the concrete has hardened appropriately, after resting for 7 days, containers are loaded in the repository, their final destination. The weight of a sealed container is 13 to 15 tons, depending on content. The load arrives in the repository area through the transport tunnel, which is 1700 meters long and has a slope of 10%. In the first stage, 2 vaults of 100 meters long each are to be constructed. 19 containers per row are placed in each vault, resulting in 519 containers, thus 1471 drums per vault. After the required waiting time, the voids between the vault wall and the waste packages are backfilled with a mixture of cement and crushed granite. Finally, the chambers are closed with a concrete plug. In parallel with the waste emplacement, the excavation of the new vaults continues outside of the controlled area. The repository's plant capacity is 40,000 cubic meters. It is enough not only for the low and intermediate level wastes generated during the lifetime of the nuclear power plant, but also for those originating from the decommissioning of the plant.